Hello, this is Baron from Ragic. I'm going to show you a really quick tutorial here about having multiple SKUs. So a lot of retailers have asked me how to create sub-8 SKU numbers under one master SKU. So how this works is usually there's a product, but the product has variations. So it has like multiple codes under one master code. For example, there might be this polka dot dress that they're working with, but the polka dot dress has a few sizes and a few other colors that may be under the same product category, but they have their own sub numbers within as well. So how do you go about doing that? Okay, I'm going to create the main product sheet first with a master SKU and go through this step by step. So what we need for the form is probably the master SKU number. And this is probably going to be entered manually by you or uploaded from an Excel sheet. So I'm just going to leave this a free text field. And then we probably need the product name. And those are probably our main two fields that we need. So let's save this first. So what we need to do is to have sub SKU numbers. So I'll add that too. And I don't know how you call this, but it's probably the same everywhere. And then let's say size, and you can have your own size options here. For example, I'll go through X, S, and this small, medium, large probably, and then XL. I know a lot of you have maybe number sizes or anything else. Anyway, I'll do this as a standard, and then let's say color. So this can also change. You can make this a selection field. If you have too many colors, you can just have it a free text field, because I guess the color will change, like teal, blue, violet, whatever, according to the manufacturer, so it depends on you. All right, so that's about it for my main sheet design. So let's create a sample here. So let's say I'm just gonna really like make this simpler. So let's say we have 251, 2, 3 as a variation. So you might have like very like separate numbers for this, but it depends on your design. The color is different in this one. Let's say it's blue. Okay. That's all there is to it, to add sub numbers under one master number. Although now there is the issue of having all the prices of the sub products the same as the master product, and some people might have adjustments to this. I mean, if you have larger sizes, sometimes you want to price them differently. So let's say we had the master SKU's price over here. Base price is what you can name it, and that turned into a mini field. And let's say that we had an adjustment. Let's say that we want to point to the base price here as well for the subtable. So you want to be able to refer to this A3 field over here, base price. So I'm just going to make this point to A3 in my database design. So that will show you how to have a base price on the subtable over here for each of these sub products. Oh, I'll also add a title here to show these are all the sub products or product variations, however you want to call it. And then the base price is there. We probably want to add another field that is a price adjustment. So if it's on sale, for example, if you have too many small polka dot dresses that are in yellow and you want to get rid of them, then you might want to have a discount here. So the price adjustment is, let's say, just a money field that will adjust the base price, and this is the sub-product price. Or maybe if it's a larger size, you want to adjust and add that base price. So the sub-product price will refer to base price plus price adjustment. So that would be, we always refer to the field headers. So it's D6 plus E6. And I'll save this. Let's just drag our title a little bit like this and save. Okay, so let's see how the calculation works. Let's say this dress was $20 at first, and you can see that these have automatically calculated. And the price adjustment, let's say, is -3 for a small size, and we don't have a price adjustment for the medium in red, but have a +1 on medium in blue. So it all depends on what you want to do in your store. I mean, some people don't have this price adjustment, you don't have to put it. All right, I'll save this, and then that's how you get the product pricing. And if you actually have to have these sub-SKU products in a separate sheet, all you have to do is create a new sheet from this subtable, which you can do from sheet linking tools over here, and new sheet from subtable. So you can generate a new sheet from your subtable. Okay, what this does is it will save all your records under the sub-products, and it will show the master SKU is what links it to the main product sheet. And this is done automatically. You don't really have to do anything else. And if you're going to add new sub-products, you can import into this spreadsheet. And if you have the correct master SKU number, it will map correctly to the products. All right, let me add another main product to show you what I mean. 251, let's say, long evening dress. And the base price is like $50. And let's say we had a few sub-products. By the way, these sub-tables, as you add new entries underneath, it will expand, giving you more space for new products. So this expands as much as you want it to. Let's say teal, blue, teal, blue. Price adjustment. Let's say we only have like $2 on the large. And save. Okay, so this should generate a sub-SKU entry for my sub-products for each of these sub-table records. As you can see, it collects each and every entry within that subtable for separate products in here. So if you need to add a field that was from the main product sheet underneath the subproducts as well, you can do that. Let's say we need the name of the product. You can see that the link fields from parent sheets shows the product, which was the parent sheet that I linked from. So let's say that I needed the name. And see, it populates automatically. All right, I hope this answers your questions about the sub-SKU. This can be done in a lot of other contexts, but this is the most asked question nowadays about this. So if you have any other questions about how to use this, or if you want to add additional things to the structure, just let us know at support@ragic.com, and we will point you to the right direction.